Praise you tonight, Jesus. We give you praise. facing difficult times right now, I'm just want to remind myself and remind anybody that's watching this or will watch this at a later time that we can't do it on our own. That might be the greatest lesson from everything we're facing right now, and not just right now, but any trial that you ever face, is that I don't have to do it on my own. The Lord is with me. If I have made him my rock, and he is my Savior, I can trust in him. Back to the beginning, can't control what tomorrow will bring, but I know here in the middle is the place where you promised to be. I walk now through the valley. Let your love rise above every fear, like the sun shaping the shadow. In my weakness, your glory appears. Yes, you come. Will you meet me here again? 'Cause all I want is all you are. Won't you meet me here again? I'm not enough unless you come. Will you meet me here again? 'Cause all I want is all you are. Will you meet me here again? Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Not enough unless you come. Will you meet me here again? 'Cause all I want is all you are. Will you meet me here again? I'm not enough. Unless you come, will you meet me here again? 'Cause all I want is all you are. Will you meet me here again? Not enough unless you come. Praise you, Jesus. God, we just praise you tonight. Lord, I feel like singing that again. God, you are our everything, God. We can't change what has happened in the past. But God, we can make a decision on what we do from right now going forward. And right now, we just want to worship you, Jesus. Go back to the beginning. I can't control what tomorrow will bring. But I know right here in the middle is the place that you have promised to be. He's here right now. Unless you come, will you meet me here again? 'Cause all I want is all you are. Will you meet me here again? As as I walk now through the valley. Let your love rise above every fear, like the sun shaping the shadow. In my weakness, your glory appears. Thank you, Lord. I'm not enough unless you come. Will you meet me here again? 'Cause all I want is all you are. Will you meet me here again? I'm not enough unless you come. Unless you come, Lord. Because I can do all things through Christ which strengtheneth me. But without you, Lord, I can do nothing. Thank you. not for a minute have I been forsaken. Oh, the Lord is in this place. Yes, the Lord is in this place. Thank you, God. Oh, come, Holy Spirit. Let these dry bones awaken. Oh, the Lord is in this place. Yes, the Lord is in this place. Oh, hallelujah. I just want to remind myself of that again. Oh, not for a minute was I forsaken. Oh, the Lord is in this place. Yes, the Lord is in this place. Oh, come, Holy Spirit. Let these dry bones awaken. Oh, the Lord is in this place. Yes, the Lord is in this place. See, we got a few people online here. Let me say hey to I see Tyler, Kingdom Structures Ministries, and I see Kendra, and of course my wife. I can't make out that next one there. Oh, is it, what does it say? Does it say the Susie Whitmire? I thought it was a company. Oh, the Susie was here. That's my mother and Becky. And I know Ricky's right there with her, so just want to say hey to you guys. Praise God. Praise God. I think that's all the songs I'm going to do because I don't want to lose my voice before I preach. I felt like it was starting to lose it for a moment there. Hallelujah. So we'll read the word and close out for tonight. God, this message tonight that I'm going to preach is called Trusting in the Lord. Trusting in the Lord, which is something we're having to do right now. I see Ricky coming up on there, so we got Ricky and Becky both logged in on YouTube. Praise God. It's good to have you guys on here tonight. Looks like we've got 15 viewers right now, so praise God. So good to have you guys. And let's open up with prayer. Ty, you may have to, I just have to move over. There we go. Praise God. Let's open up a prayer. Anybody that's watching right now, whether you are in chat or whether you're just online and you're not logged in at all, or maybe you're watching this for later on, you're not watching this live, that's fine. God can still move because He knows every hair that's numbered on our heads. So we're going to pray right now for those that are watching. Father God, Lord, I just thank You so much for this opportunity to minister Your Word. I thank You, God, for this opportunity to read Your Word, God, and to praise You tonight and to worship You, God. Lord, I thank You, God, that in the middle of this pandemic, God, You have made a way for us to continue to have service like we did this morning when we had service outside. God, I thank You for technology that allows us to be able to be far away from one another and still be able to reach one another and touch each other with the Word and reach out to each other and bless each other with the Word and lift one another up and exhort one another. Father, I pray tonight that You would just anoint this message. And God, I pray for all those who are watching, whether they're watching this live right now or whether they're watching this in a recording later on. God, I just pray that You would just touch those individuals. You know what's going on with them. You know whether if they're facing a sickness right now, whether they're facing the flu or some of the people who may watch this later on, maybe they're going through this COVID-19 virus, or God, maybe it's just allergies, maybe there's other sicknesses in their body. God, I just pray that You would just touch them right now in the name of Jesus. God, I pray that You would just reach Your hand down and bless them right now, God. Hearken unto the voice of Your people, God, and meet these needs. God, You are a healer. You said in Your Word, You said in Your Word that by Your stripes that we are healed. And so, God, I just pray that You would just touch those that are watching right now. In Jesus' name, heal their body. Lord, touch them and let them know that they're not alone, that You are with them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Praise God. they can't hear me? I'll try to move this up just a little bit. And actually, give me one second. Let me try to turn the volume up. All right, you may be able to hear me a little bit better now. Sorry about that. Until I get a few live streams down, I won't know exactly how the volume on this is going to be. So if it still isn't good, then I may have to just take this little piece off and just put it right next to me. But hopefully that's going to be good and you guys can hear me. Just let me know in chat if you can't hear. Well, let's start off in Romans 8:28, and I'm not going to keep you very long. It's 9:14 p.m. Kendra says yes, so I think you guys can hear me. Romans 8:28, and I'm going to be reading from the New American Standard Bible. At the next service that I do, I'm going to try to have the scripture up here for you, but right now I'm not able to do it. I didn't get that set up before we began. But we're going to read from Romans 8:28, and it says, "And we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose." We know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. So everything works for the good. Everything in our life works for the good. God makes sure that if you're one of his, and that's very key, that if you are one of his, that everything works for the good to those who love the Lord and those who are called according to his purpose. Psalm 37:25 says, "I have been young and now am old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread." I'm going to read that again. Psalm 37:25 says, "I have been young and now am old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread." Now, a lot of people can say, you know, I know some people that, you know, they say they're Christians and, you know, they're going through some hard times and things aren't good for them. And what's going on? Well, sometimes we face battles. Sometimes we face trials. We face, you know, turbulent times like we are right now. And we go through these battles, and those are just for a season. But there are some folks who need to make sure that they are one of his. Because if I go through something, it is only for a season. Every trial that I go through is only for a short season. And short can be a subjective term. Sometimes short for God may be 6 months. Sometimes short for God might be 7 months. Sometimes short may be just a couple of weeks. We don't know, but God doesn't want us to worry about the timing. He wants us to just keep our faith focused on him and our trust in him, knowing that no matter what happens, God is going to make a way for us. So he says, "I have been young and now I'm old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread." So let's see if you qualify. This is how you know if you qualify as being one of his or being one of those who are called according to his purpose. It says here in John 14:15, it says, if you love me, he says, "you will keep my commandments." If you love me, you will keep my commandments. So if you truly love God, then guess what? You're going to be obedient to him. You're going to be after him. You're going to be seeking him. You're going to be looking for anything that you can do and change in your life to grow. We should always be growing at all times, growing in God. We need to be finding out if there's things in our life that God is happy with. We go through the day, and sometimes we know we've done something wrong, or we know something, I don't feel right about this. That is the Spirit of God pulling on you. And he wants you to listen to him and hearken to him and pay attention to him and say, "God, I'm sorry." He doesn't want you to wait until you get into the evening time and then say, "All right, God, remember all them bad things I did earlier today? God, forgive me for all of that. God, I know that I was doing wrong, but God, I was just going to go ahead and finish what I was doing." Listen, that ain't a repentant heart. God wants us to repent at the moment that we do it. He wants to pull at our heart. When he's pulling at your heart, he's not saying, "Hey, later on tonight, ask forgiveness for this." No, he's wanting you to change right then because he's trying to change you. You know, sometimes we have, if you ever ride a horse, or if you've ever watched somebody ride a horse, I'm trying to hold this thing so you guys can hear me. I hope y'all can hear me. If you ever ride a horse, you can pull on those reins a little bit. It'll have a little muzzle over its mouth, and those reins you can pull on it in order to try to guide it to the right or guide it to the left. If I pull on it, I'm telling that horse, I want you to pull right now to the right. I want you to go to the right if I'm pulling to the right. If I pull left, I want him to go to the left. I don't want to pull and that horse say, all right, I'm going to turn right in about another 200 yards. 200 yards, I might be dead. I might be going off a cliff. When I pull on those reins, I need that horse to respond immediately to my commands so that I can keep myself as well as that horse safe. Amen? And so God is the same way. He has put his spirit inside of us to live inside of us so that his spirit can guide us. And so when he's pulling on us, he's not saying, hey, change later. He's saying, change right now. So let me read on with verse 16 through 18 of John 14. It says, I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may be with you forever. That is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it does not see him or know him. But you know him, because he abides with you and will be in you. I will not, oh man, I love this. When I read this earlier, this I just got excited about this. He says, I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Is that not a wonderful promise? Right now, some of us have been isolated to our homes. We're going out in public, and we're you know, some people are, hopefully not you, we may feel fearful, like, does that person have it? You know, I found myself the other day, I was in Walmart, and huge lines. If you've been to the grocery store lately, the lines have been just very huge, very long. And I was sitting there, and all of a sudden, a woman in the next aisle, all of a sudden, she sneezed really hard. And I looked, and every head in that building that was within earshot just turned their heads and looked at her. And she had brought her collar up and tried to stop it, and she sneezed. And when everybody looked, she did like this, and she just looked around and brought it down real slowly. Because everybody's looking at her, because everybody's thinking, does she have this virus, you know? And we have to be careful. It's important that we be careful. But it's also important that we have faith and say, Lord, someone could have sneezed a minute ago, and that thing could be in the air, that water vapor, as what the scientists say, it could be in the air for 3 hours. I could be walking through something and not even realize it. So I can't just listen to what I hear. I've got to be able to trust God and say, God, I need you to keep me through this time. I need you to keep me safe from anything that would try to enter my body that could be deadly to me. And God, I trust you and trust him. And some of us right now, we may feel like this scripture says. We may feel like orphans. It says, I will not leave you as orphans. He says, I will come to you. So you need to remember that you're not alone. God is with you. You are never alone. He's with you right now. Isaiah 45, verse 7. This is a good scripture here. This is the Lord speaking. He says, I form light and create darkness. I make well-being and create calamity. I am the Lord who does all these things. I'm going to read this again because I only have two more, this scripture and one more. Isaiah 45:7, I form light and create darkness. I make well-being and create calamity. So God is saying, I am the one who makes well-being. Are you well? Will you give God praise for that? And he creates calamity. He creates calamity. We know he creates calamity because he created Satan. Now, he didn't create Satan to be evil. But Satan had the ability to change who he was going to serve, if he was going to serve God or serve himself. And he decided to serve himself. And he's created us. And we have a free will. We have the ability to make a decision of who we're going to follow. And so there's a lot of people out there right now that are creating calamity. They're creating problems. They're creating trouble. And the enemy is out there creating trouble. Well, guess what? God made all of that. The thing, though, is he didn't make them to do those things. He didn't make them to do evil. He's allowed them, allowed the enemy, in one case, he's allowed the enemy to bring evil upon us sometimes in order to test us, in order to make us stronger. But he has also allowed people to have a will and to make decisions on their own. They can make their own decisions. I don't know about you, but we have, me and my wife and my son, we have a sticker on our wall when we come in. It says, it has the scripture. It says, as for me and my house, I'm going to serve the Lord. And praise God, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to serve God no matter what. I form light and create darkness. I make well-being and create calamity. I am the Lord who does all these things. The reason I'm telling you this scripture right now is because we see what's happening right now. Not only are economies being devastated, but we see people's lives being wrecked. I know individuals right now who have been furloughed, some who have been laid off. They're going through hard times. We've got people who, they're facing uncertainty. They don't know what's going to happen. And that's what's so troubling about this. We thrive when we know how everything is going to pan out. We thrive when we know what's going to happen. We thrive when, let me rephrase that. Even if we're not thriving when we know what's going to pan out, we feel comfortable. We can even endure loss when we know that it's coming and it's expected. Oh, man, something's about to happen. I can just tell, something's going to go on. I know it. This car is starting to act up a little bit. Once you have faced something being wrong with your car and then you find out what's wrong with it, don't you feel better once you know what's wrong with it? And then you got to figure out, okay, where am I going to get the money from it? You know, the most uncomfortable point is when you don't know what's wrong with the car because you're trying to figure out what it's going to cost. But once you know, even if it hurts your pocket or even if you go on to the next trial, which is where am I going to get this money from, you can at least feel at knowing I know what is coming. I know what I need to do. I know what I need to do to move beyond this. I got to find money or I got to get this vehicle to a repair shop. You begin to feel comfortable. So you can feel comfortable in those trials. You can feel comfortable in poverty. You can feel comfortable when things aren't working out for you. But it's not always good that you can just feel comfortable. We need to be able to trust the Lord even in the middle of uncertainty. And that's where faith is really hard. When we're in the middle of uncertainty, to be able to trust God. God wants us to be able to trust Him when we don't know where our next meal is going to come from. He wants us to be able to trust Him when we don't know when we'll be getting our lives back to normal. He wants us to be able to trust Him when we don't know when all of this is going to be over, when we don't know when the vaccine will be made, when we don't know if we're going to get the virus or not. If you get the virus, if you don't know whether, how bad is it going to be? Is this going to be good? Is it going to be just light? Is it going to be bad? Is it going to be really bad? God wants you to trust Him no matter what. You know, I remember my mama, not my mother, my mama on my stepfather's side, his mother. And I remember when she was dying with cancer, she had a brain tumor. And I remember her head was really, really swollen. I mean, she didn't look like herself. Her head was just really swollen. And I remember we were at her bedside, me and my wife, and we were praying for her. And I remember telling her, I said, Mama, I wish God would heal you. And she said, I do too, honey. She said, but either way, glory to God. Glory be to God. That's what she said. Glory be to God no matter what. Glory be to God. You know, she was uncertain about what was going to happen next. She was uncertain about what it was going to be like when she died. But she trusted God and said, no matter what God does, no matter what His decision is, glory is going to be given to God no matter what. And it sure was. And when she passed away, she went into the throne room of heaven. She went before the Lord our God, and she is still with Him right now, shouting and singing and praising God. Amen. You know, when God allows us to go through some things, He's trying to get our attention. When we're facing troubles, he's trying to get our attention. Luke 14:26 says, if anyone comes to me, and this is my final scripture for the night, if anyone comes to me and does not hate his own father and mother and wife and children and brothers and sisters, yes, even his own life, it says he cannot be my disciple. I'm going to read that again. If anyone comes to me and does not hate, yes, it says hate, hate his own father and mother and wife and children and brothers and sisters, yes, and even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Now, does God want us to truly hate them? No, he doesn't want you to truly hate them. But what he wants you to do is when it comes to God and them, he wants you to forsake them when it comes to him. He wants you to make him first. If someone in your family is saying, Sonny, I don't want you to go to church today. I just want you to stay here with your mama and just spend time with your mama. Or, oh, son, I don't want you to go to church this evening. I just want you to stay here with me and spend some time with me, and we can go out to eat. You better make the right decision and spend time with God, because the Lord says, if anyone comes to me and does not hate or forsake his own father, his mother, his wife, his children and brothers, if he doesn't make them second, his sisters, his brothers, yes, even his own life, if he doesn't make them second to even himself, God says, you cannot be my disciple. Sometimes when we begin to put all these other things in our life first before him, God will allow trouble to come upon you. He will allow persecution to come upon you. He will allow tribulation to come upon you. He will allow these battles. He will even allow pandemics. And God forbid, we haven't got here yet, but I know there's some places right now that possibly are. And we know that there are some places that were going through this even before now. He will allow you even to have famines to come upon you. He wants you to be able to trust him. And so sometimes he will allow things to come upon you so that no longer can you afford to pay for your own food. No longer can you make a way to have a shelter over your head. See, if you've got enough money in your bank right now in order to cover for your next month's rent, then you say, you know what, I love God, but I don't really need to put my trust in God because I've got enough to make it through my next monthly payment. God may take that monthly payment away. He may take that money that you had for that monthly payment. He may take that job away from you if you put that job before him. He will allow things to happen if you begin to put anything above him. He will allow trouble to come upon you. He will allow sickness to come upon you. He will even allow for your finances to be attacked so that he can make sure that you run back to him. Because we have all seen those individuals that say, you know what, I've got everything I need. I don't need God. Boy, they better take heed lest they fall. We need God no matter what. We need the Lord no matter what is coming, no matter what we're facing, no matter what's coming, even if it's good things, even if it's good things coming our way. Don't allow yourself to get on the mountaintop and to say, I don't need the Lord anymore. I'm on the mountain. There's another valley coming. God wants us to trust him. Whether we're in the valley or whether we're in the mountain, always trust him. And even right now, I want to speak right now, and I feel this in my spirit. If you have been facing fear over this pandemic, I want to speak over you right now. God has not given you a spirit of fear. He has given you a spirit of love and of power and of a sound mind. Love and power and a sound mind. He's not giving you that spirit of fear. Now, am I going to wash my hands? Yes, I'm not going to be an idiot. I'm not going to go out and touch everything and then say, oh, God's with me, and just put my hands all over my face. Listen, I've got to do everything I can. I got to do all that I can. You know, I was thinking the other day, because some people, they may be one of these folks that say, you know what, if I can trust God, then I don't have to wash my hands anymore. The disciples were walking with Jesus. Let me say this again. Jesus, the Son of the living God, his only begotten Son, when he was on this earth, they were walking with him. Now, you would think they would say, you know what? We don't need to worry about anything. We don't need to carry any kind of protection with us. We got Jesus with us. But Jesus made sure. He said, do y'all have a sword? They said, we have one. He said, do we have another? And they said, yes, we have two. He said, that's enough. Now, why would the Son of God want to make sure they have two swords? It's because he wanted to show us, even though we have the power of God with us, do all you can. Let me give you another instance. Jesus was getting ready to raise Lazarus from the dead one time. And he's before the tomb, and he's looking at the tomb, and there's a rock before because they didn't want the stench to come out. And instead, now remember, keep in your mind right now that this is the same God who said that you see this mountain. He said, if you have faith that is the size of a grain of a mustard seed, he said, you could speak to that huge mountain and say for it to be plucked up and to cast into the sea. Remember that. He said, if you just have that little bit of faith, you could speak that and it would happen. But yet he's before this stone, which is something that was hewn out of a mountain, but so much smaller. And yet he still tells some people nearby, roll the stone away. But Jesus, you said that we could speak to a mountain and say for it to be plucked up and cast to the sea. Yes, you can if you have that kind of faith. But guess what? Right now there's some able people that can come up here and they can roll this stone away. Let them do what is possible, and then let me and let God do what is impossible, which is raise the dead. Once he rolled the stone away, he couldn't tell them, now raise the dead. That was beyond their control. God loves to take over when we've done everything we can, and we can say, God, I trust you. I've done everything I can. Now, God, I need you to move. Now, I say that to tell you, when you go out in public and you've got faith, wash your hands. Get you some hand sanitizer when you get back in the car. Make sure that you do everything you can to be safe. If someone sneezes near me, guess what? They don't cover. I'm going to be pulling my shirt up, and I'm going to be praying. I'm going to be doing everything I can and trusting God for what I can't. That's beyond my control. Praise God. I want to thank you guys for watching us on YouTube. This was the first live stream. And I'm looking forward to doing more of these. Even when we get back to normal service, I'm going to try to get back to doing more of these. I pray for you right now, Father God. I just ask you just to touch everyone who is watching us live right now. And I ask you to touch those who may be watching this at a later time. God, I pray that you know what's going on in their lives. You know what they're facing and you know what they need. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you would just minister to them tonight. I pray, God, that you would just give them a peaceful sleep tonight. I pray, God, that you would just give them rest. I pray, God, that you would just remove any fear that they have away from them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want to tell you one more thing. My son, he's been ministering a lot. He won't be doing this. We were talking about having him do a streaming Wednesday for a lesson, but he won't be able to do that because I'm on a different shift. But sometime in this next week, we'll be live streaming again. Maybe next Sunday night, maybe Tyler will do that. And y'all stay tuned. If you're watching right now on YouTube, I want to ask you if you'll go and subscribe to this channel and turn on notifications so that you can get notified whenever we begin to stream. I won't even have to send you a message. You'll get a stream alert that we're live. So thank you. God bless.